You know, netball, yes. You were a star netballer, as we know.
I was.
But have you ever heard of Beauhurt?
No, Matt, I haven't.
Well,
do tell more.
Well, Mon, it's the art of historic medieval combat. And would you believe it is happening right here in Australia?
Get out of town. Joining us now are two of the Knights of Albion, Scott James and Shannon Michels. Welcome to you both, gents. Wow, you're looking mighty splendid.
Hi.
Scott, some people might think that this is just sort of role play, but it's a fully fledged sport, right?
Absolutely, yes. Yeah. So it's a full contact steel armoured fighting sport. It's very different to LARPing or cosplay or anything like that. It's competitive, it's international, and yeah, it's a sport and club, the local club that does it.
When I told you it was different to LARPing.
When you say LARPing, are we talking live action role playing? Is that the phraseology?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So it's a completely different thing. We just get put in the same category a lot by people who don't know the difference. But if you see us fight and perform, you'll understand there's nothing similar about them.
Oh, could you give us a bit of a trial? Show us what happens?
Well, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. Me and Andrew can whack each other a bit.
Okay, carefully. Ooh.
Jeez, that is brutal.
Yeah, they're not holding back.
No, they don't, do they? Do people get hurt?
Not really. I mean, it's a contact sport, so people can get hurt, just like you can in rugby or snowboarding. But we wear proper armour based on 13th, 14th century armour from medieval Europe, and that stuff worked. So all the armour that you see on right now, it's based on historical examples. We have very high authenticity requirements, and they have to be upheld when we perform and when we fight. So you don't see anything fantasy.
There.
This is all. So there's a few, obviously, like there's a few rules. No back of the neck, no back of the knees. You know,
the top of the head's
the armor
all right.
Works so well that generally the armor works really well.
Oh. Look, in sports like lightsabering, there's an element of choreographing in it. Is there any choreographing in this? Or like, do they know what's coming? What moves next?
They have no idea. These guys are fighters, and basically they've trained for years. Andrew on the right there, he's travelled internationally several times to fight for Australia. And it's just like a martial art. So we fight usually in a team. Just got a small group of people here, but we can have 5v5s, 10v10. Overseas in international tournaments, we've had 150 versus 150, and it is a sight to behold. It is spectacular.
Do you mind
and
if I just...
There's no choreography, it's just...
Sorry to interrupt. Do you mind if I just inquire as to a welfare check that the two behind you are okay? I feel obligated to.
Yeah. How are you feeling?
No, we're good.
Oh, that's
got
Shannon.
A few of those.
Andrew, you okay?
I did... My thumb popped out and I copped a sword hit straight to the thumb. That's why we stopped.
Oh.
So little things like that happen.
Well, just a little thing.
Just a mega thumb pop.
Yeah, a mere flesh wound. Wow. Well...
No, that's all right.
Thank you for enlightening us this morning. Sorry, Scott, what were you going to say?
Oh, no, I was just going to say, so these aren't sharpened weapons. We have lots of rules in our sport, so there's no stabbing. They're all blunt surfaces, and we have very strong rules and regulations and weight restrictions on weapons, depending on what the weapon is. Just like any sport has really strong rules for the equipment that they use. And to an extent, that keeps you safe. Safety is a big part of our sport. And we always have marshals and referees in the fights that we do.
Oh, that's a good
thing too. To make
sure
that everyone's welfare is always looked after.
An amazing insight. Yeah. Thank you, guys, for that insight this morning. Quite incredible.
We'll be back with more after this.
You're welcome.